Congratulations to all the winners and everyone who participated. But before we go, here are some final thoughts on how you can become Metro Atlanta Chamber's next Business Person of the Year.
Definitely be prepared when you come before the judges.
Everyone was not prepared and passionate. No, they were not. There were some really, really good ones, and some people kind of bombed.
There was a few that weren't as prepared as you would have expected. There was a few that, as CEOs of companies, you were a little surprised by.
There's an amazing class here at the Chamber on your elevator pitch, essentially, and it was easy to tell who had taken that and who hadn't taken that.
Many people were not prepared for that elevator pitch, and in fact, as a business coach, that's one of the things that I work the most on, because people historically talk about their business from the place that they are, from being in it, which is pretty much often the opposite of what they need to be able to be saying to be able to sell it.
Well, I think people are intrigued by a really good story. Like, if you can tell the story of sort of where you've been and where you are, which a lot of people did, but also the story about where you're going. You know, where is my business going to be 2 years from now, 5 years from now? And the more clarity you have on that, the more compelling it would be for a judging panel.
There's some folks that told us they didn't need one. But then going through midway, I said to myself, you know, this is why you should have joined that class, because again, it would have, you know, helped you a hundredfold, and you would have been more prepared. You have a good business, but you don't know how to sell it in, you know, 3 minutes.
At the Chamber, we really want to help businesses learn to be able to express what they do in a unique, sexy, interesting way that captures your attention, that prompts people to follow up with more questions about your business. You know, a good elevator pitch should not answer the questions, but should bring questions out of the listener.
People are no longer tolerating people who aren't authentic and don't get what they're doing and have a purpose and a focus.
Having a struggle, I think, is a part of a great business story as well. So I think the person that we choose will have to have experienced their lows, their highs, and really right now be the picture of success, and I think a model for future business leaders to look up to.
You want me to say the CNN thing again?
Yeah.
Well, actually, last year, CNN called me the Simon Cowell of small business. I don't know if that's good or bad, but there it is.
Close the doors.
Really hard to
open. I can't take it.
No, no, we need to know.
I think all of the judges are great, except for Chris Hanks, who is considered worthless.
Work her question into your comments.
I said, yeah. No, it's I knew, but I knew what you meant, and I'm like, ooh.
That's what I told her, I just put her microphone on.
But yeah, when you're talking about how great the beer is or ice cream and you don't get any, you know, that's always kind of a negative thing. But
you know, I have a horrible feeling that song could be a hit.
Yeah, I'm gonna get my pants up. I'm gonna buy some belts after this.
I just wish they could keep on tune and remember the words better.